Books are thin, books are fat, books are thick, books are flat. Some books are classic, others are dumb. There's one on every subject under the sun. William Shakespeare, Harry Potter, written by Mrs. Rowling's daughter. Philip Roth, Dr. Seuss, E.B. White, and Marcel Proust. Now science courses, books on horses, B-books, tree books, all for you. Mysteries and histories, who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Oh, Holden, Caulfield, Nancy Drew, Long John Silver, and Tarzan too. I love Captain Underpants and the Hunchback of Notre Dame from France. Astrology, astronomy, books on World Wars 1 and 2, they're a politics and parlor tricks. Who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Shel Silverstein and Oscar Wilde, Henry James and Julia Child, Maurice Sendak, Caleb Carr, and the rest, well, they know who they are. Some books have pictures, others don't. Some you'll get and others you won't. Some books are boring, but most are fun. There's one on every subject, including the sun. Who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Ooh!
Hi, welcome to Woodstock Library Today and Tomorrow. Today I want to tell you about a project we're working on to digitize the Woodstock Times. The library owns the Woodstock Times from its very beginning, from 1972 to present. And each year we send the Times out to be put on microfilm. We have a microfilm reader printer that people can use. And we've now started digitizing. We started with the very beginning, 1972 to 1978 is now online. And the great thing about, there's a lot of great things, but most especially, there's no index to the Woodstock Times. So for the digitized years, it's actually searchable by keyword, which makes a huge difference in doing research in the Woodstock Times. Now, if people are looking for something, they have to literally go through each page of the paper to try to find it. But as we do this digital project, it'll be a lot easier. So I'm going to show you how to get to it on our website, which is woodstock.org. Ready? Okay, so you can find the digitized Woodstock Times on our website, woodstock.org. And then in the top right-hand corner, if you click on local links, it's the first one that comes up, digitized Woodstock Times 1972 to 1978. You click on that, it'll show you the years that we have done so far. We want to do as many years as we can afford each year until we have the full run done. So it starts with 1972. You can search the entire, all the years that we have on here now, right from this box. If you want to go through the paper page by page, you can click on the year. You can also do it month by month. So I just want to show you 1972 was the very first Woodstock Times. So here we have Woodstock Times, page 1, 1972. And volume 1, number 1. So it looks just like the paper. It's scanned actually from the microfilm. That's how they get the best copy. And it has the article and all the photographs as well. From here you can page through. Just want to show you what it looks like. You can also do the normal things like save it to your computer or a disk. You can print it from here, you can email it, you can upload it to your cloud if you have one. And there's ways to make it bigger also when you're reading it on the screen. So we're just going to go back here to the first list. So from here, let's just say we're going to go to 1976 and say we want to search for a library and see what comes up. So this is searching the full text of the Woodstock Times through an OCR scan. The first one that comes up is photographs from the library fair. There's an ad from the library. News from the West Hurley Library is also coming up. And various articles. This one is about Woodstock Library finances now, budget at $35,000 a year from 1974. So it's really very powerful that we can do keyword searching on here. The other thing that people ask for a lot is obituaries. So we're going to type in obituaries and search them all. So here this one comes up. Somewhere there's an obituary for Jennifer back here. So you can make a more complicated search. You could type an obituary and then a name. And if the person happened to have passed away between 1972 and 1978, it would show up on here. But like I said, we're working on getting the whole run of the paper up on this website. So like I said before, we have the full run of the Woodstock Times from the beginning to the present. The very beginning we now have digitized, which I showed you can find on our website. The rest of the issues we have in microfilm that are available at the library, which you can use our reader printer to do research on. And the most current 2 years are actually still in print. So we hope to see you at the library where you can check out this fabulous resource.
Hello. This is Stuart Auchincloss, President of the Board of Trustees of the Woodstock Library. My part of Library Today and Tomorrow is to describe what a pivotal year 2015 is going to be for this library. The first thing I want to say is that our director, Amy Raff, has resigned. She's going to be with us through the end of May and then go on to the next step in her terrific life. We're going to miss her. And I hope that the library is going to continue with its new director being the bridge between the old and the present and the new technology that is so helpful in Woodstock. I know it's great for me to have the library where I can try out apps or try out technology before I get it. Some of it I think is useful and some of it I don't think. And the library has been a great place to help me make those choices. As far as replacing Amy with a new director, the position is a civil service position. And so the board has notified the Ulster County Civil Service that the job is going to open up in June. And this Ulster County Civil Service is now asking the people on the Library Director 1 list if any of them is interested in the job. There are 12 people on the list, but the list was created in November of 2013, so perhaps they've found other work since then and won't be interested. If three of them are interested, the civil service will send their names to the library board, and the library board will interview them and make a selection. If none of the people on the list now are interested in the Woodstock job, then the Ulster County Civil Service will advertise the job, reopen the list, and other people will take the test, and then we'll eventually get a list with the top three names for the Woodstock Library job. In addition to this, 2015 is going to be the year we start to update our master plan. In March, the Woodstock trustees decided to hire an architect who's really smart about libraries to take a look at our library and our building and what we do and give us suggestions for the best way to meet the library's space needs for the next 10 or 20 years. At the moment, after director, Amy Raff, told us that she was resigning, the board has put that process on hold until we have a new director in place who will be part of selecting the architect and part of the creation of the new master plan. During the interim, while we have no director, after Amy has left and before the new director is hired, reference librarian Jessica Kerr has agreed to serve as our interim director. And so you'll see the same friendly faces, and the library will provide the same high quality of service until the new director is in place, and I hope long after the new director is in place. Another thing that's going to be different and probably better in 2015 is the library fair. I know the Friends are working on making this fair better than it's ever been. And so I hope that you can join us for the new library fair on Saturday, July 25th. It's going to be a good one. So, 2015 is going to be a year of real changes around the Woodstock Library. We'll have a new director. We'll have an updated master plan, and the library fair is going to be bigger than it, or better than it's ever been before. I hope you'll stay with us for the whole ride.
I'm Dorthea Marcus, and I'm chairman of the new outreach committee of the Woodstock Library Board of Trustees. And we were just formed recently so that we can help reach out to more people in the greater Woodstock community. We realize that not everyone can come when we do a town hall meeting or some stone soup discussion, that we feel that we would really like to find out, really going door to door, like census takers, and talk to our neighbors in different Woodstock neighborhoods and communities, and find out what people like about the library, what things they would like us to do that we're not doing yet, what kind of things they would like us to do if we get more space, whether it's behind the library, across the road, or on the moon. Like, where would, what do people want their library to mean for them? And we have several people on the committee who are not board members. We have Jill Fisher, who's an urban planner and designer. We have Jerry Washington, who's a retired IBMer. And we welcome anyone in Woodstock who has some time to contribute to the library to join us, because we're going to be spending the summer really canvassing all of our fellow citizens to come up with the very best library for Woodstock.
Hi, I'm Michael Hunt, Vice President of the Friends of the Woodstock Library. And there's just a couple things we're working on for the summer months that we wanted to talk about. One being, we did our first ever scholarship awards this year for two Woodstock town residents that are high school seniors going off to college. And we are in the process of choosing from the applicants right now. And it's been really a great experience for all of us just to read these essays and understand what a depth of talent these children that we're raising in this community are. Just amazing. So people want to be novelists. People are already writers. People are musicians and assistant librarians and just fantastic stuff. Just the volunteer and the extracurricular activities these applicants do is just amazing. And it just it was really great to see all of them talk about their personal experiences with the Woodstock Library and what it meant to them. So we're very excited. The first time we're doing this, and we had a raffle last year with the Mountain Valley Little League, and the proceeds that we netted from that are going to these scholarships, and we hope to do it every year to some deserving seniors. We're also planning to kick off the warm months. It's been such a long, hard winter for so many of us that we are planning on kicking off the warm months with something very interesting. With the laundromat property that we own, and until we go through the master plan and we figure out as a community what's going to happen here in the future, we decided to take the laundromat space and half of the parking lot from the laundromat, and with volunteers and with donated materials for the most part, we're going to create a pedestrian pocket, a little park with a sculpture garden, basically. We're going to, basically, it's going to be a bulletin board, we're calling it, but it's much more than that. It's going to be an organized bulletin board. Anyone in the community can put up a flyer, an employment section, an event section. We're going to really clean up the flyer look, and everybody can go there and post your event or your activity. In addition to, we're going to have panels with magnetic panels where we can do magnetic poetry. It's going to be an interactive sculpture. We're going to have a chalkboard on some of the panels, and we're going to have chalk out there so people can just draw things and write little stories if they want. We're going to have some outdoor patio furniture. We're ripping off of Frank Gehry's early years when he would just take found things and design things with stuff that they found. And so we're going to have outdoor patio furniture so moms and dads and family can hang out while the kids create art on the walls. And then we're going to do a bench that is also going to be a sculpture. It's going to be attached to the front of the laundromat. And it's just going to be a flat board that's going to just curled out the end and be a bench. And we're going to have an event to kick off the summer, an art happening where we're going to do a painting, a community painting on that piece. And all kids and of all ages are welcome to work on that. I'm sure he's going to be working on it too. Yeah. And that's going to kick off the summer. We're hoping, this is going to be a June event, and then that'll stay up through. It's just a temporary art sculpture park, and that'll stay through the fair. And we're in the process of planning the fair right now. Of course, great music just to show off how talented a music community we are, and we're getting the Lekker truck this year. In addition to all the fine food that we normally serve, that everyone's used to eating. Lekker is a new restaurant in Stone Ridge from the people who brought you Oriole 9 and Yum Yum. So Lekker in Dutch is like means delicious or good food or something. So that's gonna be really excited. Of course, a beer and wine garden around the Lekker truck, and we're gonna do fun things again. Like last year, we had a crossword puzzle, a history of Woodstock, that I know people just stood there all day on a dry erase board and worked on that. And, I think we had maybe 80 clues in this crossword puzzle, and I think there were one or two that were blank at the end of the day. And we're just going to have tables out with chess and checkers, and people just want to have a nice quiet time in the corner playing a game with someone. And lots of the old vintage, old-fashioned kids games. In addition to some fun stuff this year, we're going to do, I believe, a carousel for the smaller kids. Like, you could go on the carousel, go on the horse, go around and around. I think that's from, like, 1 to 5-year-olds. And then we're going to have some sort of inflatable obstacle course that is for the older kids. We're trying to, with story hours, all the activities here we do for the younger set, we want to make sure that, the preteens and teens can enjoy the library as much as they did when they were like this age. So this obstacle course, I think, is for like 5 to 16-year-olds can run through this thing. And so we're just kind of livening up the kids section a little bit. And in addition to the book fair in the back will be, of course, everything everyone always expects it to be. I got some great books at last week's book fair. And vintage clothing and used clothing, that tent, and antiques will be back too. And then they were really successful the last couple of years. So we just want to remind ourselves that we're just caretakers here for this very special event. It's 84th annual, and we hope that the community comes out like they always do under sunny skies and enjoy themselves. July 25th from 10 to 4 right here at the Woodstock Library.
Hi, I'm Elaine Hammond. I'm a trustee of the library board here in Woodstock, and I'm retired. I was a clinical nurse specialist in psychiatry. When I first came here 33 years ago, of course, the library looked pretty much the same, but I've certainly found it a resource over the years, and well, I found things wrong too, but gradually it got to be more and more perfect. Now it's pretty good. In terms of what I like to read, I like to read just about anything. I read the back of cereal boxes. I guess I've always been that way. But the book that I just finished reading, Maeve Brennan's The Long-Winded Lady, was sent to me. It's an old book. It's not a new book. I think 1989 or something. But they added some excerpts they added some contributions, I guess, she made from later on. It's called The Long-Winded Lady. She was a writer for The New Yorker. They have a column called Talk of the Town right at the beginning. And they have contributors, and they sometimes make up funny names for them. Or she made it up. I don't know. Anyway, she's The Long-Winded Lady. And these were contributions made by The Long-Winded Lady. And I got it in an interesting way. My cousin sent it to me in the mail because she had read it and thought that I would be interested because I lived in the village at the time that this lady lived part of the time in the village, and that she was in New York, a fairly youngish woman, though she's older than I am. And she wrote about a lot of places that I knew and had visited and hung out. And actually, even my cousin had come to visit me and stayed at the Hotel Earl. So she talked about a lot of stuff that was familiar to me and even to my cousin. So I just finished it. And after I read it, I thought, not to take anything away from her, but, you know, if I'd had any kind of skills at writing, I could have written this book, and so could a lot of us, because any young woman who comes to New York on her own is going to have interesting experiences. But now this lady moved a lot. That was the big feature I noticed, that starting in the late 50s, when it was possible to do that, she must have borrowed apartments from people because she writes a lot about where she lives and the neighborhood and how New York, of course, was changing even in the 50s and 60s. And we know the pace has accelerated. But I'd really recommend it. It's a quirky book. It's an odd book, but it's especially for those people who lived there or wanted to live there or thought about it, or read The New Yorker a lot. It's very nostalgic in a way about all the places, Sixth Avenue, and when it was Sixth Avenue instead of Avenue of the Americas. But just for those of us that the city meant a really lot to, and going up there, obviously on our own, to make our fortune or whatever we went up there for, it's really an interesting book. So, our library, I think, is a good library for a lot of different reasons. Right now, I'm computerless, and I go in there to check on my emails and look stuff up and whatever. And they've always been very helpful. I think that for quirky books that are not found anyplace else, at least I've never found them anyplace else, they have a lot of really interesting, unusual books. They have a lot of art books that I could probably move right into the art room and stay, just read. They wouldn't like that. So I really really have a lot of positive feelings about our library, of course.
Books are thin, books are fat, books are thick, books are flat. Some books are classic, others are dumb. There's one on every subject under the sun. William Shakespeare, Harry Potter, written by Mrs. Rowling's daughter. Philip Roth, Dr. Seuss, E.B. White, and Marcel Proust. Now science courses, books on horses, B-books, tree books, all for you. Mysteries and histories, whodunit, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Oh, Holden, Caulfield, Nancy Drew, Long John Silver, and Tarzan too. I love Captain Underpants and the Hunchback of Notre Dame from France. Astrology, astronomy, books on World Wars 1 and 2. There are politics and parlor tricks. Who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Shel Silverstein and Oscar Wilde, Henry James and Julia Child, Maurice Sendak, Caleb Carr, and the rest, well, they know who they are. Some books have pictures, others don't. Some you'll get, and others you won't. Some books are boring, but most are fun. There's one on every subject, including the sun. Who done it, how to do it, why they do it, what they do. Ooh!